So we have this laptop from a world-recognized firm, Anus. Why Anus, you may ask? Because Republic of Gamers. It was shipped with 16 gigs of RAM, DDR4 in this particular case, and since the RAM is not soldered to the board, you decided to upgrade the amount of RAM from 16 gigs to 32 gigs by replacing both of the sticks. However, even though the RAM you installed is 3200 megatransfers, which translates to 1600 MHz, which is the maximum this laptop supports, it doesn't seem to work at its maximum frequency, which should be 1600 MHz. Instead, it works at almost stock speed, which is 1333 MHz. However, the stock sticks that you have removed, that kit of two 8-gig sticks, which makes it a total of 16 gigs, was working at 3200 megatransfers. If you try to Google how to solve this problem online, most answers will rotate around going into BIOS to enable XMP overclock for the memory. However, since this is a laptop from Anus, even though the BIOS or UEFI BIOS looks fancy and beautiful, it really lacks in features. There is almost nothing there. In this case, you will be advised to install a modified version of BIOS, which unlocks all the settings. The place to go is one of the forums dedicated to BIOS modding. However, first of all, they don't publish any files. You are supposed to communicate with some person on that forum privately in a personal direct message for him or her to have a look at your BIOS, and modifying it usually requires some kind of a donation. And of course, flashing a modified BIOS is a risky operation. It may render your laptop unusable, you will most certainly lose your warranty, and in many cases, the laptops don't even accept unsigned BIOS. And if something goes wrong, you will need a hardware flasher to restore your BIOS. Anyway, even if everything goes smoothly, there is no use unlocking the hidden features on this particular laptop or any Anus laptop in general, since even if you do unlock those settings, they will do nothing. They will not apply. Another somewhat less dangerous way to achieve the same thing is to use this program from GitHub. This is only for AMD Ryzen processors. This method doesn't really modify the BIOS, it changes some configuration files that the BIOS uses, which actually can help to achieve the results you want, however, you are doing that on your own risk. However, the question remains, why the stock sticks were running at 3200 megatransfers just fine, however, the new sticks you installed don't? And the answer is quite simple. The RAM modules the laptop was shipped with achieve maximum frequency, which is 1600 in this case, at 1.20 volts. However, your new sticks reach the same frequency at 1.35 volts. And the trouble is, this is an Anus, okay? So it doesn't use XMP at all. It only uses JDAC profiles. That means the RAM will only work at 1.20 volts. And the maximum speed these particular sticks can reach at 1.20 volts is 1333 MHz, and that is exactly how your RAM is currently clocked. So the correct way to replace or upgrade RAM on this particular laptop is to get RAM sticks that only use 1.20 volts across all the frequencies. In this way, they will always work at the maximum frequency they support or the laptop can handle, which is 3200 megatransfers in this case. This is DDR4. For DDR5 laptops, the idea will be the same. The only difference is DDR5 laptop memory works at 1.1 volts.
I'm the god of YouTube!
Like, subscribe, jingle bells.